The discipline of rigorous practice and an engagement with the self is essential for every artist. Through conversations and performances, G5A Forum's Morning Riyaz brings back the focus on refining every note and the silence in between.
Good morning. I will be speaking about a topic that I've had a lot of discussion with my grandmother and my great-grandmother about, and that is the sum. Basically, the sum, as a Shastra, brings discipline to any kind of creative repertoire. Does it limit the artist's creativity? But I don't think so, because I think it works as a tool to aid him in the unending vista of exploring the bhav of an atmosphere. So I'm going to talk a little about what my great-grandmother, Gana Tapaswini Srimati Mogubai Kurdikar ji, told me about. Not just some, but about matras and lay. So, firstly, the sum is the first beat of a cycle of beats. Now, the cycle of beats would be 16, 10, 12, 7, 4 even. And after every cycle comes the first beat, which we call as the sum. What essentially happens when the sum arrives is it establishes the end of one cycle and the beginning of a new one. Now let's talk about what the artist, as a musician, what he tries to do is, I'm trying to express something. Essentially, whether it's a poet, it's a painter, an actor, or a musician, we're trying to express something. And if we all know that music is called a language of notes. Now if it is a language, why don't we just look at it like we look at every other language? Languages that we speak or write. So, in spoken language or written language, when we express something, it's either through a poetry or somebody might write a blog. So there are paragraphs or verses which have a beginning, a body, and an end. And the end usually has a full stop. Similarly, every paragraph or verse has multiple sentences or statements, which also have a beginning, a middle, and an end, where there is again a full stop. So when I am trying to create something, when I'm trying to express a vatavaran, which is very abstract, of course, the sum helps me in projecting that full stop, where I begin with a bandish, and the bandish usually starts at the first avratan, the first cycle. Some bandishes end within one cycle, some take about two or even three. But where the bandish ends, that's where the poetry or the song, the expression that is being conveyed through the poetry comes to a conclusion. So where the poetry comes to a conclusion, it is usually a few matras before the sum, the first beat of the next cycle. And we establish that by singing the sign line, which is the first sentence of the poetry. And we land at the sum. What the sum does is it beautifully establishes that completion. After that, what a musician does is, in singing, we do the alapi. Now the alapi is actually an extension of the dialogue that has been started in the bandish. in keeping with the bhav of that particular rag. So every dialogue is going to start somewhere, is going to have a middle, and is going to end and have a full stop. So wherever the full stop lands, I have to finish it at the sum by taking the mukhra and landing on the sum. Similarly, when I start a dialogue and I come toward the next sum, the mukhra changes according to the alapi, because the artist tries to, it is an extension. The entire repertoire of one particular rag is essentially an extension of a dialogue that we started at the bandish. And to establish that full stop and to start, give me a definite point to start a new dialogue, the sum is extremely important. Now, whether it limits the creative ability of an artist, I don't think so, because when a dialogue or a statement could be a really short one or a very long statement. So if I want to sing a very short dialogue, if I want to create a very short statement, then I would start somewhere around the middle of the cycle of beats that I am following and land at the sum. If I want a little bigger dialogue, I would start immediately at the first sum. Sometimes I want to create a really big statement, then I would surpass one sum and go and land at the next sum after that. But that sum which I just surpass is very vital, because it gives me an indication of the span of time that I have to complete my dialogue. So now I'll come back to what my great-grandmother told me is, let's talk about matras, the beats. Between two beats, the time span spent between every two beats establishes the lay, which depends on the emotion that you're trying to express. Now, every emotion has its own different lay. If you feel anger, if you feel sorrow, if you're joyful, elated, the lay, the tempo is very different. If you express anger, you will have a different tempo. If you express sorrow or joy, they each have their own tempo. So the tempo of the performance is decided upon the expression. And that is established and clarified between two beats. Similarly, the entire cycle of beats could be 16 beats or 8 beats. So from the first matra, which is the first sum, to the next sum, that span of time remains consistent. So it gives me an idea of the lay. The lay continues, and it gives me an idea of the beginning of a span of time, the beginning of a cycle, and the end of that cycle. So sum is very helpful, and it in fact aids the artist when he's trying to just explore a rag which is so infinite. So there, sum keeps us on track. Now, the artist, what I have been studying with my grandmom is how to use it to my benefit. And I'm going to try and demonstrate it here. And for which I have chosen a rag, Lalit Pancham. And the bandish is set in a cycle of 10 beats, which we call as the Chaptal. And you will see a clear indication of the sum. And there is a medium point, which we call as the Kal or Khali, which lands exactly between two sums. So I'll try and demonstrate that now. Rag Lalit Pancham.
Thank you.
Ah. I hope I was able to demonstrate what I spoke about. So now, of course, the drut was in another tal, but I began with a jhap tal, which was a moderately slow lay, which we call as the vilambit. I've chosen my second rag of a bandish, which is again jhap tal, but it is a little faster in tempo. And it's in fact the very style of Jaipur Gharana to not sing in Ati Vilambit. We sing close to Madhyalaya. So I will try and demonstrate how the sam comes in handy and also how the beats come in handy to demonstrate the lay at a faster tempo. And I'm going to present it in Raag Husaini Todi.
Thank you.
Hearing two strikes. Ah. Should I just sing Maru Pranam for you?
Better.
Thank you.